The story you're about to see isn't true, but it could be. It takes place just about anywhere and anytime, and it involves a young man named John Lafitte.
Hi.
John was a member of a group called The Body, which was made up of both men and women, and had quite a noble purpose to help other people. The Body was led by an older man named Mr. Headley. And once every week, he and John would get together with the other members of The Body and talk about their work.
Doris Littman.
As per usual, Mr. Headley, I marked my place at the right time and place, and on behalf of the others, I'd just like to say what a pleasure it is to be here.
Thank you, but a simple here would have done, Miss Littman. I see clearly.
Here, and it's nice to see you.
Well, it's nice to see you too, Miss Clearly. Are you listening?
I hear you, boss.
Good, Mr. Listening. Hans Armstrong.
I am here, I think.
Yeah, you're here, Hans. And John Lafitte.
Here.
Okay, good. I'm Brian Headley, and I'm here, too. So much for roll call.
Mr. Headley?
Yes, Mr. Lafitte?
I'd like to propose that we go out and we find people that need help. You know, the poor, the people that don't have any home or food.
Oh, very good, John. Does anybody have any suggestions?
Oh, I do! Well, first we have to find them, right? I mean, it's no good trying to help people if you don't know where they are. So maybe we should have someone kind of like look out for the needy people, you know, just kind of look and see where they are and find where they are. Kind of like that. What do you think?
I think that's a good idea, Miss Littman.
Oh, I'll do that, Mr. Headley.
Well, John, that's very nice of you to offer, but I think watching is more your line of work, I see.
Yes, it is, Mr. Headley.
But she always gets to be the lookout.
Well, John, that's only because she's so good at it. Remember, it was IC who spotted the poor people we helped last month and the stranded family that helped, we helped last month before that, right?
Yeah, I remember.
Okay, now after IC spots them, what do we do then?
Oh, I have an idea! Well, then we have to talk to them. Open lines of communication, you know? I mean, they're probably really down and depressed and sad, and I don't know if I'm really down and depressed. Nothing cheers me up faster than a good talk, you know what I mean?
I know.
But that's only half of it, ain't it, Mr. Headley?
What do you mean, are you?
Well, it's not enough for us to just talk to them. We gotta hear what they have to say, too, don't we?
I was wondering when you're gonna bring that up, and both you and Miss Lipton are absolutely correct. We need to talk and listen to the homeless.
Oh, I'll do that. I'd be really great at that, Mr. Headley. Really?
Yes, John, I'm sure you would be, but I think these jobs are more suited for RU and Miss Lipman, don't you?
Yeah, I suppose.
Okay, after we've talked with them and heard what they had to say, what then?
Well, whatever they need, of course.
Like what, for instance?
Oh, like chopping their firewood, or mowing their lawns, or painting their walls, or plowing snow. We can plow snow, or we can mop their floors, or there's just a million things we can do. What do you think? Do you think those are good ideas?
Yes, Miss Lipman, we certainly could.
Oh, I'll do that, Mr. Hurley. I can do that really good.
Well, John, you know that Hans Armstrong, he has a lot more experience at that kind of work than you do. I think we ought to let Hans handle it. What do you think, Hans?
Yeah! I do.
But if IC's gonna watch him, and Miss Lipman and Ari are gonna listen and talk to him, and Hans is gonna do all the repairs, then what am I gonna do?
Well, we're gonna need someone to take us out to the homeless people after IC spots them.
But that's what I do every time. I wanna do something different.
Now, John, you know, our organization works best when everyone does what they're good at.
Yeah, I know.
All right then, what we'll do is we'll be back here in the morning and then we'll go downtown, okay? Dismissed.
And so even though John seemed to understand, he wasn't really very happy. So after the meeting, He and IC clearly talked about it on the way home.
IC?
Yeah?
Do you ever get tired of any of these meetings?
Only once in a while, but then I think about all the people we helped, and I'm not tired anymore. Why?
Sometimes, a lot of times, I really get tired of it.
Oh, you do? You used to like it a lot.
Well, now that I never get anything out of it, and it, all I get is work, it's always the same kind of work, I want to do something different.
But John, you come so you can help people.
I can help people anywhere. I don't have to come here to do it.
But then where would you go?
Nowhere, baby. Or maybe I just help people myself. Yeah, I'll start my own group. I bet there's a lot of people out there just like me that do the same thing and want to do something different.
I don't know if that's a very good idea, John.
Oh yeah? I'll show you. You meet him tomorrow, tell him I quit.
Quit? But John, you can't.
I just did. Bye, I see.
John! Oh, no.
And so the next morning found a very excited John putting together his own group, which he called the Lafittes. He was right about one thing. There were a lot of people out there who just felt just like he did. And before long, he and his group of followers were making their way downtown to find people who needed help.
This is great!
Okay.
And that's just what they did for several weeks, in fact. They moved up and down the streets watching and watching and watching. But after a while, try as they might, they just couldn't seem to find anybody they could help. The only person they saw day after day was a well-dressed man who just sat on a bench. And that gave John an idea.
Hey! That guy sits there every day, so I bet he knows this neighborhood really well. Maybe he knows where we can find people that need help. Hi.
Hello.
My friends and I were just wondering, why you sit here so much?
Well, it's because I kind of live here. I know that sounds weird, but a few weeks ago, my house burned down, with all my money and everything I owned in it. The only thing I was able to save was this suit. And because I worked out of my home, the fire destroyed my source of income as well. I really have nowhere to go other than this bench.
Oh, well, see, we're here to help people.
You are?
Yeah, and we're just wondering, since you sit here a lot,
right,
if you know where there are any.
Any what?
People that need help.
No, but if I see any, I'll be sure to let you guys know.
Oh, really? That's great. Thanks a lot. Well, we gotta go. See you around. He's gonna help us, man. Find people to help.
Yeah. Right.
Needless to say, nothing ever came of that. Several more weeks passed, and John and his Lafittes became more and more discouraged. Then one day, they noticed that the well-dressed man wasn't sitting on the bench anymore. So they went into the nearby diner where they always had lunch, and they asked Marge, the waitress, about the man.
Well, if it ain't the Lafittes, how are you?
Good.
Great.
Oh, not so good, Marge.
Oh, about it.
Oh, sorry to hear that. Did you use one can usual?
Yes,
No, I'm not hungry.
Are we? No.
We were just wondering if you know what happened to the well-dressed man that used to sit on that bench.
Ah, you mean Mr. Dominell. They told me I had to leave.
They? They who?
The authorities. They said that bench was there for people to sit on and wait for the bus. Not for him to live on.
Live on? You mean that bench is where he lived? He didn't have a home?
Nah, he lost that and everything else he owned in that fire. Didn't you know that?
Well, now that you mention it, you know, he did mention it when we talked to him. But if that's the case, why did he promise to tell us if he found anybody we could help?
Well, I don't know. If anybody around here needed help, it was Mr. Down and Out. You probably just didn't hear him, right?
No, I guess we didn't. Any idea where he is now?
There's no telling.
I can't believe it. Not only did we not spot the one person that needed help, but we blew it when it came to talking and listening to him. I bet the people in the body would have made that mistake. And we were going to help people.
Well, listen, if you still want to help somebody, I could use some.
Really? What?
Well, actually, it's my sister.
Oh, you want us to find her?
No, I already know where she is.
Oh, you want us to talk to her or repair her house?
No, she's not been feeling well.
Oh, and you want us to take care of her?
No, she went to the doctor and the doctor gave her some meds and told her to rest. But she has 5 hungry children.
And you want us to make her some food?
No, I already took care of that.
Well, what do you want us to do?
Well, I need somebody to take the food over to her.
Not again.
You see, she lives way across town and I gotta stay here and work.
Back to delivery work.
Well, if you don't mind.
No, come on, let's grab the food. Let's go.
Oh, brilliant.
I think she was this one.
And so, food in hand, the Lafittes made the journey across town to deliver the food to Marge's sister. But you know, after they delivered it, they noticed something very peculiar.
You know, that really felt good.
Yeah, it did.
I really felt like I was helping someone.
Yeah, me too.
I haven't felt that good since I left the body. Since I left the body! No wonder nothing's been working out. I've been trying to do things I'm not any good at. I've been so dumb.
Dumb, dumb, dumb.
Oh, thanks a lot, guys. Well, I'm not going to be dumb any longer. I'm going back.
And so John broke up the Lafittes and raced back as fast as he could to the little building where the body had met.
Mr. Haley, Hans, strong feet, but come back. Are you? Miss Lippman, it's me. I'm back, I'm home. Hey, what's going on here? What's all this strange furniture? What's happened?
John Lafitte, is that you?
I see. Oh, I see, it's so good to see you again.
But I thought you were going to start your own group.
Oh, I tried to, but I really messed it up. I learned now that I should do things I'm good at and not what other people are good at.
Oh, if only you realized that sooner, John.
Well, the good thing is I know it now. Hey, where is everyone? I want to get back to work.
Well, they're all gone, John.
Gone? Oh, you mean like out helping people?
No, I mean gone as in left, moved. The body has been broken up.
Broken up?
Yeah, I just came back to get the last of my stuff. Everybody's gone on to different jobs. Hans joined the circus as their strongman. Mr. Headley works for a computer company. Miss Littman is a telephone operator. And RU edits radio programs, and I'm a lifeguard at the beach.
But why? The body was so good at helping people. Why did it have to break up?
Because when you left, we couldn't get to the people who need help.
You mean just because I wasn't here?
The body couldn't do what it was supposed to.
Can't we get back together?
It's too late. Goodbye, John.
But...
Goodbye.
No!
And so, both groups dissolved. And even though each of the members went on to different things, they were a lot sadder. For once, there was a group that helped people. But now there was just an empty room. The body in it had died.